Bishop, in my bedroom at St. Agnes Rectory, I have one statue, and it's a small little statue of St. Martin de Porres. Somebody gave it to me when I was a little boy and said, this saint, holy saint, attracted so many men to the life of faith, and I hope he attracts you.
One of the great Catholic saints of Lima, Peru, a Peruvian saint, and his background's fascinating. He has a lot to say to us today in the 21st century. He was the illegitimate son of a Spanish nobleman, Don Juan de Porres, and Ana Velasquez, a freed slave from African Native American descent. And he professed religious vows as the Dominican lay brother in 1603. What was so fascinating about Martin, he experienced terrible racial injustice. And yet he was a conqueror because he conquered in a spirit of love, forgiveness, magnanimity, joy, peace. He had these beautiful kind of apprenticing in the healing arts, but also had this great kind of mystical capacity to intercede for people in their physical, emotional, and spiritual healings. St. Martin de Porres shows us that the people who are consistently meek, mild, gentle, and who ground that meekness and gentleness and humility of heart in the power of the cross of Christ are incredible forces in the church and in the world. I've made some beautiful visits in July of 2010 when I spent a month in Peru. I often prayed at the small black marble tomb of St. Martin de Porres. He was canonized by Pope St. John the 23rd. So we pray for that beautiful sense of racial harmony, that beautiful sense of racial justice that St. Martin de Porres modeled with such charity and mercy in Lima, Peru in the 17th century. St. Martin de Porres, pray for us.